From the icy tip of Mount Everest to the dark abyss of the Mariana Trench, life on Earth thrives. Ultimately, this is because three basic requirements are met. We've got water, the right chemical ingredients, and energy. But the Earth is not the only place in the solar system that meets these criteria. This is an image of Europa, one of more than 70 moons of Jupiter. Now, Europa is roughly the size of the Earth's moon, but that's where the similarities stop. Rather than being covered in dust and rock, Europa is covered in a thin shell of ice that surrounds a global saltwater ocean. This ocean is warmed and kept liquid by energy from Jupiter's tidal forces, which constantly stretch and relax the moon, generating an internal heat. Now, Europa is thought to have the water, the chemistry, and the energy that are all required for life on Earth, making it a very appetizing target for future exploration. My research involves designing trajectories through space which would allow spacecraft to safely land on and explore Europa. But this is a daunting technological challenge for a few big reasons. For starters, Jupiter has an incredibly strong magnetic field. It traps thick belts of radiation that threaten to roast any spacecraft that lingers too close for too long. Further, Jupiter is huge. It has more than 300 times the gravitational pull of the Earth. This means that as a spacecraft from Earth approaches and begins to fall towards Jupiter, it will speed up and up and up until it's screaming through space. Now, at these speeds, we have managed to slow down and land on other bodies in the past, but only those with atmospheres. This is because an atmosphere allows for the use of parachutes and heat shields to passively slow down our spacecraft. Unfortunately, at Europa, we aren't afforded the luxury of an atmosphere, so we have to slow down with rockets. Now, slowing down from such great speeds requires a lot of fuel, which, due to weight constraints, limits the number of scientific instruments we can bring along to study the ocean. My research seeks to save fuel by taking advantage of the complex gravitational interactions between Jupiter and its moons to naturally slow down spacecraft and allow for a safe landing on Europa. Now, my favorite part about this research, aside from the fact that I get to spend my days thinking about aliens, is that the work doesn't stop with Europa. There are at least 8 other bodies in the solar system that we also suspect of having subsurface oceans. Determining if we're alone in the universe, it's not just a goal of NASA. It's a fundamental question to humanity. Through my research into low-speed landings on ocean worlds, I'm hoping to help answer it. Thank you.